Make a statement on the tennis court with the KSwiss Hypercourt Express. Building on the success of the previous playtester favorite, the Ultra Express, this update features a newly designed upper for added support and a fresh new look. The rest of the shoe is virtually unchanged and continues to provide plush cushioning and a running-inspired feel. First up, we have Tiffany. Now, you playtested the previous version, the Ultra Express, as well as you have a wider foot. How'd this work out for you?
Well, I really love that Ultra Express, and similar to that, this one has immediate comfort. As soon as I slipped on the shoe, I noticed the cushioning. It's really plush and has a bit of a gel-like feel, so very supportive as well. And I enjoy the wider fit in the forefoot, so I really like that. When I got down onto the court again, I still could feel that great cushioning. Court impacts were never an issue. Where I did have an issue, though, was on hard stops. I would feel my foot sliding forward, and I had to tie my shoes pretty tightly and actually retie them quite a bit during play to try to minimize that effect, but I never could quite get it to stop altogether. Overall, I enjoyed the traction and the really actually great toe durability of this one. Ventilation was decent as well, but just overall could not get past the toe jamming issues that I was having.
Next up, we have Carly. You were also a fan of the previous version, the Ultra Express. What did you think of this update? How did it compare?
Well, there was a few differences that I noticed right off the bat, and that was the durability and weight. To me, this one felt a little bit heavier, but that durability was better than the previous version. And like Tiff, I agree with the toe durability. It just had great coverage above there, and the step in comfort was great. The padding around the ankle is just a very soft shoe right from the very beginning, no break in at all. However, for me, after about 5 hours, that's when I really noticed the shoe to loosen up, and I have a bit of a wider foot, so even so, I was moving around within the shoes. And like Tiff, especially on forward stops, the toe jamming was a little bit of a problem for me, so I wish there was a little bit more cushioning in the toe part, but around the ankle, that comfort was great.
Next up, we have Michelle. Now, the previous Ultra Express, you were known to wear both on the court as well as in the gym. What do you think of the Hypercourt Express?
Yeah, I like this shoe. It's very plush and cushioned, as all the other playtesters have mentioned. Really comfortable, automatic stepping comfort. So I could enjoy it both on the court and in the gym, for sure. The only slight issue I had was I did find the fit to be a little wide, not too long, but just a little wide. So stability was a little bit compromised here and there. But overall, I really enjoyed the traction. The durability was just as on par as with the Ultra Express. And the plush cushioning kept me really comfortable on the court. Overall, it wasn't too heavy, so I really enjoyed that I didn't feel weighed down on the court or when I was working on explosive movement. The only issues I had was that slight issue with durability, and I did not love the cosmetic. I really wish KSwiss went with those really bright, fun colors that they did with Ultra Express. But overall, a super comfortable shoe.
I also playtested this shoe as well as the previous version, and the biggest difference I noticed, like the other playtesters mentioned, was the wider fit. When I put my foot into the shoe, I noticed great plush cushioning underfoot, under the heel, as well as the forefoot. And after a couple hits, I really appreciated the cushioning around the ankle collar, as well as the tongue. Since I had to tie the shoe a little bit tighter because I have a narrow foot, this plush tongue really helped prevent any pinching or rubbing I might have had. The weight for me was about average. It felt heavier than the previous version, as well as its actual weight. But comparing it to other tennis shoes, it was slightly lighter than average. My one issue I had with the shoe was I just could not get a secure fit with my narrow foot. My foot was moving side to side when I was moving aggressively, as well as I did get some toe jamming like the other playtesters when I was making abrupt stops. Overall, the shoe had great cushioning, just was too wide for me. For more information on this shoe, please check it out online at tenniswarehouse.com. Thanks for watching.